We were looking through tapes. We were searching for things.
Sometimes you might get back, you might get a box back with 10 1-inches in it, and you didn't know which one you needed to use because you didn't have this piece. The logging sheet had been separated from the correct tape. So you'd open this up, all this wasn't even in it, and so you didn't know what was on the tape. And so you'd have to send it up to the machine room, book an hour of their time, or maybe 2 hours, or maybe 3 hours, for them to check through to find a piece of music, and maybe it wasn't on that tape, and you'd have to go down and you'd have to get another box and look through another load of tapes. So it's quite a costly business. So this sort of whole logging that we used to do manually, you can see this is handwritten, it all had to be done manually, and we did it manually, all the logging of all the tapes that we did. It was really important. This paperwork was really important, and pieces of paper went missing. I remember getting into a skip outside the pub in Camden, going through bins looking for tapes in a skip because we couldn't find it and needed to go on air. I think that was a low point. Think, well, we're just going to have to get in the skip, and we're going to have to look through these back bin liners, because we don't know where the tape is, we can't find the 1-inch, so we're going to have to search. And we went through so many tapes, we found the tape, there you are, and it went on air. But that's having looked, I mean, how it ended up in the skip, that's a whole other story, but